Hello, welcome back. So now in this part, we will discuss about a brief introduction to the bamboo. Well, bamboo is again a very important construction material, which is used from the centuries for constructing buildings, structures, bridges. So this is again one of the oldest traditional building material. And this bamboo actually belongs to a grass family, and they are actually the fastest growing in the world. Well, how fastest? You can see a bamboo can grow up to 1 meter even within 24 hours. Within 24 hours, a bamboo can grow up to 1 meter height. So that is very huge, fast growing in the bamboo, and therefore they are the fastest growing member. So as I said, bamboo as a building material can be used in the construction of scaffolding, bridges and structures, houses. So like you can see here, this is one of the example of bamboo bridge in the northeastern region. So now bamboo, originally, it is associated with the region of Southeast Asia, where there is tropical, subtropical regions, and which is actually suitable for its growth. So it is, the cultivation of the bamboo is in the northeastern regions and in the Thailand, Malaysia, and even in the South America. So these are the regions which are most suitable for the bamboo cultivation. So now coming to discuss more about the bamboo. Well, bamboo can be converted into various shapes if we do proper detailing in this. So bamboo can be of squared cross section. During the growth of the bamboo, if we place this within a square pipe, so this can attain the shape of the square. Similarly, if we want to have a banded shape, or if we want to bend a bamboo in any shape, we can have that banded shape also. If we bend a timber in the desired shape in the young age, it can attain that arch shape, the desired shape in the normal manner, and in this case it cost lesser than it would get to the same from the normal timber. Similarly, even up in the normal bamboo, we can bend the bamboo after applying various operations, like by the application of the heat, by the application of the pressure. So we can achieve that bending in the bamboo. So with this, we can ascertain that bamboo can be of any desired shape. We can have any desired shape of the bamboo very easily. Now, if we discuss bamboo as a building material, how we use bamboo in the building? Well, we can utilize bamboo for the construction by using the technique of structural framing. Structural framing technique is basically the technique in which we have a column, we have beam, we have walls, roof system. So if all of these are connected with each other, so that technique is the structural frame technique. And in this, what we have bamboo floors, walls, roofs. They are interconnected with each other, and they also rely on each other for a great stability, or for a better stability of the bamboo structure. So here we will see the contribution of the bamboo in various forms. For example, can we use bamboo in the foundation? Well, using bamboo in the foundation is very limited. Why? Because if we make directly contact of bamboo in the soil, well, it may decay fast because of the chemical present in the soil, or also because of the presence of the moisture in the soil. So because of this, bamboo may decay fast, and therefore we are required to apply some chemical treatment to the bamboo before using in the foundation. So yes, we can use bamboo in the foundation by applying some chemical treatment to the bamboo. Also, sometimes we can use bamboo construction compositely, like we can embed the bamboo in the concrete blocks. For example, this concrete is constructed in the foundation, and within the concrete we can embed the bamboo, and then we can start our bamboo construction. So that is also a way to use bamboo in the foundation. So bamboo are used in various shapes and forms to build foundation. So one of the example here you can see, this is again a very good example of bamboo. So here you can, this lower part is of concrete. It is constructed of concrete, and bamboo is embedded within the concrete. And these curved part, these cross bracing, these are basically the of bamboo. Similarly, the roofing material can also be of bamboo. So yes, bamboo can be used very effectively within the foundation along with the concrete. Bamboo can also be used in the wall construction for making walls, partition walls. So in this we use bamboo in two manner, one in the form of beam and the second in the form of post. So by this combination we can construct a bamboo wall like this. So here you can see there are various example of bamboo wall. In this vertical bamboo is known as the post, and the horizontal bamboo is known as the beam part. So these are various example of bamboo wall. Sometimes for more rigidity to the wall, sometimes we use infill within the wall, which may be say mud. So if we infill mud in this, we can have more rigidity to this wall. So they are positioned in such a manner so that they can withstand the horizontal force of the nature. Force of the nature is simply the wind or earthquake. So bamboo can also be used in the roofing system, because bamboo is very stiff and it is highly sturdy material. So we can use bamboo as a roofing materials also. So here you can see here, this is the bamboo roof used effectively. And yes, it is a proven shield against the force of nature or animals, and are considerably light weighted, which makes them easy to install. So yes, bamboo is light weighted and it can be easily transported. It can be easily installed. So now here, if we discuss the advantages of bamboo, well, bamboo is highly strong in the tensile strength. The tensile strength of the bamboo is very high, and it is so high that it is higher than steel. You know, the strength of bamboo, I mean the tensile strength of the bamboo is higher than steel, because its fiber runs axially. So here also the grain direction matters. So grain direction is along the length of the bamboo. So therefore, if we try to stretch bamboo, the tensile strength will be higher than the steel. Now, if we talk about the fire resistance, well, bamboo is having very high fire resistance because of the presence of silicate acid and water. So if we add water, there is the presence of silicate acid and water, and because of this, bamboo can withstand temperature as much as up to 400 degrees Celsius. So that is the second advantage, very important advantage of bamboo. Third is the elasticity. Bamboo is having very high elasticity, and it is widely preferred in the region where there are chances of earthquake. So in the earthquake prone regions, bamboo is widely used and it is highly widely preferred because of the high elasticity elastic feature of the bamboo. Bamboo has high strength, low weight, so therefore it is light in weight and it can be easily displaced, it can be easily installed, it can be transported very easily because it is lightweight. And unlike other building materials, bamboo poses no danger to the health. So for example, if we use cement in the concrete construction, so in the cement manufacturing, there is a very huge pollution. But if we use bamboo in the construction, it poses no danger to the health. It promotes the green building architecture. So bamboo is highly cost effective and very easy to use, and therefore they are highly in the demand in the earthquake prone area. So that is the advantage of the bamboo, but there are some disadvantages of bamboo also. And one of the disadvantage is it requires preservation for its proper protection. And second one is the shrinkage. Bamboo shrinks more. So bamboo shrinkage is much greater than the timber when it loses the moisture. So when moisture content is low, it shrinks very, very high. So that is one of the problem. So because of this shrinkage problem, it is difficult to use in the construction. And second is the durability. So because bamboo is an organic material, and if we don't treat it sufficiently against the insect or fungus attack, it may decay. So therefore the design life for the bamboo structures is low, or it requires continuous maintenance. Jointing. Well, although there are various joinery details for the bamboo elements, but still we don't have a reliable joinery methods. And because of this, because we don't have reliable joinery methods, the full strength of one of the element cannot be transferred to the other element. So therefore this jointing is also an issue. And because of this jointing issue, we are not able to use bamboo with full efficiency. So that is the brief description of the bamboo as a structure material. So thank you. We will continue our discussion in the next lecture.